But I got to give credit where credit is due. I cannot say enough about what the Brooklyn Nets are doing. It's fantastic. I want to give props to D'Angelo Russell because we all know what kind of mess he got himself in by stupidly exposing Swaggy P when he was involved with Iggy Azalea. That brother needed to be moved out to L.A. All of us said it. He has come to Brooklyn. He has been balling.
Everybody on this channel should pretty much know exactly why my profile picture is what it is. A lot of people like to come over here and figure I'm some type of new bandwagon net fan because of my profile picture when that's not what it is at all. It's because of D'Angelo Russell, my personal favorite player. Now, recently, I've been into some heated debates, even with some of my personal favorite people on YouTube, about D'Angelo Russell and pretty much how his career's hype died down post-Brooklyn. I've even heard some people throw out the narrative that every place D'Angelo Russell left got significantly better. Well, technically you can say that's true, but that's like a blank comment with absolutely no context, like none at all. Let's not leave out exactly why these teams got significantly better. Let's not forget Magic's magical plan to replace D'Angelo Russell with Lonzo Ball. That blew up in their face, bro. Like, LaVar Ball and the circus-like atmosphere he created for LA, that didn't work. If it wasn't for LeBron saving them, we don't know where they would be right now. Brooklyn, they got the chance of a lifetime to get two of the most skilled, decorated players of all time, Kyrie Irving and Kevin Durant, so they had to bite on that. And Golden State, I mean, we all knew that was basically an asset provided by Kevin Durant being extremely loyal, so D'Angelo never had a place there long-term anyway. But let's bring this all in to the summary of this video, and let's talk about why the 2018 Nets were a pretty big deal, especially for a franchise that was pretty much an NBA hell. As we all know, in 2013, the Nets, they made what is now known as the worst trade in NBA history. Essentially, they traded for three old, clearly out of their prime stars in exchange for their entire future for the rest of the 2010s. What made this trade look even worse is how quickly that Big Four, Big Five, coached by Jason Kidd, how quick that team turned bad, which ultimately made the trade look even better for Boston. Brooklyn's plan almost immediately failed, and they couldn't even make a conference championship with that Big Five in that weak, top-heavy-ass Eastern Conference with LeBron changing teams and all that. Once they completely gave up and traded away all their old-ass pieces and all that, they had to roll out rosters like this and watch Boston create their next chapter with their picks that they should have had. Look at the Nets' records and their rosters post that Big Five. I mean, it was terrible, and all they were basically doing was brightening up Boston's future. I remember people didn't even know who Spencer Dinwiddie was until he won a skills challenge. Like, nobody knew who he was. Then, in 2017, they went all in on a young, pretty much giving up on talent in LA, and they at least made him the face of the franchise, at least temporarily. Now, for D'Lo's first season in Brooklyn, I mean, he was hurt for a big-ass chunk of the year, so you really couldn't grade him on that. But for the next season, basically with the exact same identical team plugging in a D'Angelo Russell that was healthy, you could see how it was panning out. This team, they were projected to win 28 games by some people, 29 games by some people, 30 wins by some people, 32 wins by some people, and they started out their season 8-18 pretty much on pace, exactly what people projected. But they finished their season off 34-22, and they actually made the playoffs, led by some extremely heroic performances by D'Angelo Russell.
Picked up by Kuzma. Russell.
Sitting at 36-36, on the brinks of missing the playoffs once again, this team had one of the greatest fourth quarter comebacks I've ever seen, led by D'Angelo Russell. They were down by 20 points in the fourth quarter, and this man just put on a show, bro. After this, they finished their last 10 games out 6-4, pretty strong, made the playoffs, and they just did the unthinkable. Now, I know a lot of y'all are probably asking, why the hell are you making a video about a team that was the 7th seed and got eliminated in 5 games in the first round? Well, it's pretty much exactly what I did with that Lakers video. Like, appreciate the roots of it. Yeah, the Nets are good now and they got Harden, Kyrie, and KD and all that. But appreciate this team that kind of started the trend of the Brooklyn hype. If you can't appreciate D'Lo, Caris LeVert, Jared Allen, Spencer Dinwiddie, and most importantly, Kenny Atkinson, bro, you don't deserve to appreciate this, bro. Also, this team produced one of the greatest NBA videos of all time, so let's appreciate that too. Until next time, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and stay tuned.